So I've been selling on eBay and Amazon from past 10 years. During this time, I launched 207 private label products on Amazon, and I have over 5,000 listings on eBay. As an experienced full-time seller, I share a lot of tips on this channel which can help you grow on eBay and Amazon. But sometimes those tips are not very useful for new sellers. So a lot of people will come back and tell me, Zen, this is something that you have started 10 years ago. If we are starting something today and we're gonna start in 2022, how this is gonna be helpful? We're gonna have a new account. We're not gonna have any feedback. We don't have any experience in a product research. We do not have a budget as much you have to start and launch a new product as well. So recently, about 5 months ago, I started a new account on eBay. So first of all, let me show you the back end of that, how much money I'm making on that account, because I always like to be very transparent. So here is the back end of that eBay account. I have around 100 listings on this account right here as well. Today, the sale was about £22. In last 7 days, £448. And in last 90 days, it is £816.78. So the point which I'm trying to make here is that I can even show you a daily kind of, a payout on this account as well. So if I go to the payout here, then you can see the daily payout on this account. Sometimes there are around £200 per day on this account as well. To be honest with you, if I was working in some kind of job, I could completely just leave that job and rely on this one, because easily my profit per month on this account is around between £1,000 to £1,500 after all the expenses. So if you are working somewhere as a minimum wage, that is the kind of money that you probably will be making. And I spend about 3 to 4 kind of hours every single day doing packing, listing, all that kind of stuff as well. And a lot of that is a retail arbitrage and a drop shipping. So I don't really have to do a lot of stuff as well. So in this video, what I want to share with you is the 10 tips, 10 things that I actually learn, which can be very useful for someone who is just starting their journey or want to sell on eBay and Amazon, and they don't know what to sell, where to start, how much it's going to cost you. So these all 10 tips are going to be very useful. My name is Zencha. This is what we talk about on this channel, about eBay and Amazon, how to make money online. So I will really appreciate if you press that like button. That really massively helped my channel. And at the same time, if you're not the subscriber for this channel, please do subscribe to this channel as well. So the first tip will be, feedback does not matter. Regardless how much feedback a seller have, I'm not just gonna say that, I will give you a couple of examples as well. If some of you selling on eBay already, you might notice that you get a lot of orders at one particular time. So within probably one specific hour or at the one specific time at the day, you will get a lot of orders. So what eBay does at that particular time, they will kind of switch the algorithm. They will actually give a preference to new seller over the old seller as well, to give them a same opportunity as much they are giving opportunity to their existing seller. Because don't forget, eBay is at the end of the day making money from the sellers in terms of fee, all that kind of stuff as well. So they will like to encourage and keep the new seller on the platform because they are making money from them as well. So they actually switch the algorithm where if at that particular time, if the buyer will search something on eBay, they will find your listing as a new seller. So I don't want you to get discouraged that you are starting from zero and you don't have any feedback. If you're starting from zero and you created a new account, I always encourage that first of all, use the account to buy something from eBay. So you will get a little bit feedback. As a buyer, you can get that feedback as well. And you will be in the good books of eBay. Once you will just keep on buying from eBay for a couple of weeks, after that, start listing. I will not recommend anybody to actually start listing as soon as you create your account. So this is something you have to keep in mind. So the second tip will be that the tools are not important. important as much you think they are important. Let me give you a couple of examples as well. If you start selling on eBay, there are a couple of tools that might be very helpful for you, and you might feel like you should sign up for those tools. I got nothing against those tools. I personally use them for my product research as well. So the tools like Zeek Analytics, tools like eBay TerraPeak, when it comes to Amazon, tools like Helium 10 and Jungle Scout, those tools can be expensive in the beginning. But once you're an established seller, obviously paying, you know, 15, 20 pounds per month for a tool is not the cost that you will be actually keeping in mind, because you're making money out of the business. So the point which I'm trying to make here, that no tools will exactly tell you sell this product and you're going to make this much profit, and here is a supplier in China, we're going to do all the stuff for you, because that's the kind of feeling we get that we need to subscribe for this tool. Tools are there to minimize the risk once you are buying a product from China by giving you some analytics what's going on inside the market. But as a new seller, once I started selling on eBay and Amazon, I had no idea, to be honest, how to actually read those analytics and what those analytics are telling me at the end of the day. Obviously, I will come to what to sell and what you should do instead. But in the beginning, don't think like that you are not really willing to invest in those tools and you will not have any kind of chances to succeed on eBay and Amazon. It is completely wrong. You are very okay not to subscribe for any tool in the beginning, but later when you think you have a little bit of experience, then you can, you know, go ahead, because those tools are very helpful at that stage when you know how to read those analytics as well. Number three is the most of the question that people will actually struggle is what to sell on eBay. What can I do once I'm starting to sell on eBay? Shall I have a particular niche, or shall I be like, I can find anything, then I will sell that, I make some profit out of it. What can I sell at the end of day? So let me give you some examples. Okay, so I personally sell mobile phone and accessories. Once I started selling mobile phone and accessories, this is only thing that I knew about. Another example I can give you, that there is a friend of mine, his wife is, you know, she likes cooking, she likes to be in the kitchen. So she started selling the spices, and she used to go to Asda and used to buy the spices from there and then sell those online, along with easy to understand recipes that she started selling on Etsy, and she had a great success. And then she just, you know, started her own brand, started getting spices from Pakistan, and she used to, you know, put her own brand on it. And it came to the point where her husband decided to leave the job to help her to run the business, because they were simply making more money as compared to the jobs that they was doing at the past. And another viewer of mine who, you know, regularly watch my videos as well, he's very interested in electric bikes. So electric bikes, like, he's always interested in looking for the batteries and parts and all those kind of stuff as well. And he's having a good success by selling those things at the same time. So the point which I'm trying to make is, don't chase something where you think there is a good money. Like, for example, you watch my video and say, okay, Zan is selling mobile phone and accessories, he's making good money out of it. You have to just kind of sit back and think, what do you actually know? Most of the people, they will struggle to find the products because they are trying to get into some kind of niche which they do not understand. You can find to sell the products in any kind of hobbies or interest that you will have. Trust me, that can happen. But in the beginning, I always recommend that stick to what you actually know at the end of the day. But a lot of people tell me, Zen, I don't know. Like, I don't know where to start. Like, what can I do, to be honest with you? So I always recommend them, you can start by doing the stuff very easily. So for example, what you can do is just simply go to Amazon best sellers, okay? And then Amazon will actually give you the list. If you put like UK or US, wherever you are, that's like most things that I will recommend that you stick to the country. And then you can see the best sellers at the moment here are the bottles, and they are going for this much money. Then obviously I will go find some supplier on Alibaba or find some local supplier. So this is something, and this is the candle as well. So by showing a candle, another viewer of my channel, they was very interested in a candle, so they looked for the suppliers to make a homemade candles inside the house as well, and they started selling a candles, and they found a very great success in that kind of business. But there is something that you have to keep in mind, is that if you want to make good money out of eBay and Amazon, you know, if you want to make good money in your life as well, this is what I will always say, that you have to come out of your comfort zone. In order for you to get rich, you have to make massive changes in your life as well. So if you are not really kind of giving your times and effort looking for a supplier, by the way, we have a complete supplier list in our Facebook group as well, which will give you a very good idea where to start. So Facebook group is for the channel member, it's just $3.99 a month. I will leave the link for that inside the description as well. But the point I'm trying to make is, like, you have to really sort of, go out there and look, not just because, like, you think this is the category that you probably will be making good money out of it. I always say stick to what you know, and it will be very helpful at the end of day. Number four, a lot of people, they will think too much. For example, they will say, okay, I'm gonna start selling on eBay, and I'm gonna do this, I'm gonna do that. For example, I will look the price here, I will look the price here, I will look the price here. And then they will find some item and they think, okay, who gonna buy that item? Like, who, it's a complete trash. Who gonna buy this? But what I found, if you really list it anyway, there is a saying that one man trash is another man treasure. You know, you literally never know who they're gonna buy, what gonna sell at the end of the day. So the example which I'm trying to give you here is, once I bought the mobile phone, which was Samsung J series from Europe, and they came from Europe, and inside there was a charger which was 2-pin charger. In UK we use 3-pin charger as well. So once the product was selling, I used to take out that charger and put the 3-pin charger inside the box, because, customer, obviously they are in UK, so they need the product which is useful in UK. And then I thought, okay, then now I have about 300 of these chargers. They are 2-pin chargers, and who gonna buy that? But I said, I'm just gonna list it anyway, because this product actually really didn't cost me anything. I made my money out of these products. They was the part of another product. But if I can sell them, even if I make £1 out of it, that will be completely fine. So I listed those items and they started selling. I don't know why the people was buying, to be honest with you. Probably they was traveling into the Europe and they decided to buy this charger. I have no idea why people was buying it, but that product actually sold within 1 month, 300 items. And even if I made, let's say, £300 to £400 out of it, that's the money which I didn't had before. So I always think, okay, some people will talk about, okay, if I'm gonna sell it, I'm gonna make a very small profit out of it. So it's not really worth my time. And I always ask them, what you will be doing otherwise? Like, after you sell this item, you're gonna make some money that you didn't had yesterday. It's a lot better than, watching a Netflix or playing games and all those kind of stuff as well. Anyway, at the end of the day, you did get the point. The number fifth I'm trying to tell you is, price doesn't matter. If I see a product and I say, okay, there are sellers who are selling cheaper than me on eBay, but my cost price is expensive because I have a little different item, the buyer can actually see that. And you can, it really gonna depend on how good you are to elaborate the quality of the product by having, let's say, a decent images. Once I'm listing a product, I don't really see a product. Once I'm doing a product research, I don't just see another person price, another seller price, and I compare my price with it. I always see how their pictures look like, how the description look like, what kind of feedback they are getting. if they are getting a feedback like, okay, the color is not good, or, you know, this is a cheap plastic, or this doesn't really fast charge my mobile as well, I will highlight, like, my charger is a fast charging. It will charge your phone faster. It is a good quality. So I keep all those things in mind as well. I have a product on Amazon at the moment, and the price for that product is $14.99, and you can easily find that product for little as $4.99, but I still sell those product because I have a nice feedback and reviews out of that. So if you list some product, and even a couple of people in the beginning, they will say this product is a really good quality, the buyer can understand that this is a good product as compared to cheaper products as well. So, you know, you can either be Primark, or you can either be some, you know, decent brand. And you know that even the, you know, I'm not trying to bash Primark here, but I always, like, if you buy some kind of things from Primark, after a couple of washes, you know that it's not gonna look good, you know, if it's a t-shirt or if it's a trouser. You wash it one, you wash it twice, either it will become, I don't know, more big or more small. That's what, you know, happen always. So buyer and a customer, consumer, have a very good understanding what they are buying. So for me, I'm not always on the cheap side, and I'm not always on the top end. I always, you know, stay in the mid range and try to give them a best experience as much they can. Number six, I will talk about, in the beginning, obviously, you're going to have less feedback. Feedback doesn't really matter in the terms of when the eBay have to show your items inside the search. As I mentioned in the tip one, they're going to show it anyway because they will like to keep you. But to get more sale, and, you know, by looking at the feedback, 1 out of 10 people, they will decide to see your feedback and what kind of feedback you are getting. It gives them reassurance. Once they see you having a nice feedback, it will be very easy for them to actually make a purchasing decision at that particular point once they will see a good feedback. So I always encourage you to actually ask for the feedback in the beginning. You can actually have a cards. I've been having a really good success on my new account as well, because I'm including a feedback card inside the package. You can buy them for really cheap on eBay. They are not very expensive. So encouraging a feedback is very important in the beginning as well. Number seven, I will say, understand the cost. Because in the beginning, we do realize, yes, okay, I buy this product for this much price, I sell it for this much price as well, this will be my profit. But there are a lot of costs that you have to keep in mind. For example, you have your, you know, eBay fee, your eBay payment processing fee, you have your packing cost, you have your shipping cost as well. And don't forget, at the end of the day, you will have to pay the tax. So in this scenario, I always recommend that you have a very decent software where you actually keep the track of each and everything, and which can help you to do your tax return as well. So I personally use Osome. The thing with Osome, that they have a software which can link with your eBay account, which can link with your Amazon account. If you bought something for your business, you can simply take a picture and you can include that inside. And at the same time, if you have some accounting and bookkeeping question, they have chat function inside their software. You can always ask them, like, if they have any question about, you know, accounting and bookkeeping, and at the end of the month, they will actually do your tax return for you as well. So there you can start with their, you know, the cheapest package. You will get £100 off by using the link inside the description as well. So the thing with it, the tax side of it is also covered. The HMRC side of it also will be covered. But at the same time, by looking into their software, you will understand what your expenses are, how much money you are making at the end of the day, you know, so you will have a good understanding of the figure of your business. So, you know, I use it. I recommend it as well. The link is inside the description. The next thing that we have, learned to read the analytics. This is number eight. When I say learn to read the analytics inside the eBay Seller Central, there are a couple of things that you have to keep very close eye on. For example, how many views you are getting on your listings. If you are getting less views, you will change something inside the title, or we will change something inside the description. So in those terms of, you have to see how many views you are getting per month, or, and your click-through rate. I went into more detail on this one as well. I will link a couple of videos inside the description, which will be very helpful for you to, you know, get more feedback and learn how to read the analytics as well. That video will be inside the description. Number nine thing, pictures are everything. If you can spend more time improving anything, I will say your pictures. And at the same time, what I will like to tell you that if you take a pictures and copy them from a Google or copy them from another seller, algorithm on eBay and Amazon, they are smart enough to figure out these are not your original picture. Any algorithm on eBay, Amazon, Google, YouTube, they will always prefer to promote the original content. It means by that content was created from the scratch by the original person, not copied from somebody. So I always say your own bad looking pictures are a lot better than the pictures that you copy from somewhere. But buyer, once they will see the listing, they are actually buying the pictures. They can't see the products. So if you can improve one thing and you will see massive difference in your sales, improve your picture. Number 10 tips is not more kind of tips, but it will be my personal advice to anybody. I will say it takes time at the end of day. If you think that you're gonna start selling on eBay and you're gonna make millions overnight, you must be daydreaming. You know, these things take time. But if I tell you, and you might not understand at this point, if I tell you few years from now on, and in your case, that could be few months from now on, because, you know, you have a lot leverage as compared to once I started, I didn't had all this information. We had to figure out everything on our own. So if I tell you that, you know, a few months from now, you will be making this much money, but all you have to do is just stay patient, stay consistent, and keep on adding more products as much you can. Spend a lot of time understanding the analytics, improving your feedback. Think it as a business, give it as much time you can, but few years or few months from now, you will be making this much money. Would you quit today? And I can tell you your answer will be no. You know, you will say, okay, I'm going to continue under any circumstances. So just stay consistent. And if you like to know more about my product research method, how I do the product research in a free way without spending any kind of money, I'm going to link two videos inside the description. One will be buying something from China at the same time, like how I buy from Alibaba, how I find a supplier as well. And another will be just focused on how I actually use a different free tools to find the product. Both videos will be inside the description and I'm going to link them right here as well. Make sure you check them out. And the link for Osome is inside the description. By clicking on that link, it will take you to the page where you can just put your phone number and your email address, and they will call you back and you can ask them any accounting question, any business setup question. They can help you with the company formation. You can ask all of those questions for free. It's a free consultation call, and then you will decide if you want to go for some package or not. And the link for that is inside the description. You will get £100 off at the same time.